Hello everybody. My name is Saurabh Chatterjee from Sia Photography. I'm a travel photographer and today I'm going to talk about how to take pictures of star trails.
So I'm in the library module of Lightroom. I have already imported all the pictures. So we have 112 pictures here, which has been taken for the star trails. And you see all the pictures of the same exposure of the same setting. So this is the setting I have used, 30 seconds f2.8 and ISO 3200, and you see how the stars are moving. And there's one picture which I kept, the last picture you will see is I have underexposed the picture. So this is because I want to get the details of the monastery. Okay, so in all these you see I have lost the details of the monastery, and even if I reduce it, you see some parts are totally washed out. So this will the details will be gone here. So what I'm going to do is now I'm going to select all the pictures, command A or control A, and I'm going to edit one picture. So I'll just use the auto settings here, and I will basically underexpose the stars. So you see the brightness of the stars will be multiplied, so I'm going to keep the exposure little low. Okay, so I can just see faint dots. Okay, so pretty much you see this is an underexposed picture, and maybe I'll just reduce the highlights and increase the shadows if you want. Okay, so this is as per your taste. So I use little bit of dehaze and clarity, and you can do a little bit of sharpening if you want. Okay, sharpening with masking. So yeah, so I'm holding alt on my keyboard and increasing the masking button to control the amount of sharpening that is happening. So after I'm done, I've already selected all the pictures by pressing control A or command A, and then I will click on sync, and I will sync all the things. I'll just check all and then I will sync. Okay, so now my settings are sync. Now the next step is to open all these pictures in Photoshop. Go to photo and you have to edit in, and we are going to choose this option, open as layers in Photoshop. Now what this will do is it will create one layer for each and every picture. So we have 112 pictures, it will open all the 112 raw files. Now if you are working on a raw file, it will take quite some time, so you have to be patient with this. It probably take 15 to 20 minutes depending on what system you are going to use. And or otherwise you can just work on the JPEG file. You can export all of them as JPEGs and then work on the JPEG file, so whatever is convenient to you. So again, you can import the JPEG files and then open all of them in as layers in Photoshop, so you can work like that as well. So right now I'm just going to click on this and see what happens. Now we are in Photoshop. We have added all the layers. Okay, you can see all the layers here. So I'm going to select all the layers except one, the last one, which I did for only blending for the monastery. So you can see I have selected all the pictures, and I'm going to choose the blending mode as lighten. So the moment I do this, my star trail is created. Okay, and you can see the exposure of my stars are perfect. Okay, so because I underexposed the picture and they got multiplied, you see now I got all the details of the stars. Okay, but you see the monastery parts looks little overexposed, and I'm going to correct it. So first I'm going to merge all these layers into one layer. So you can see the merging of the layers is done. So all these layers have been compressed into one layer. Okay, now this layer is for getting the details of the monastery. So what I'm going to do now is to create a layer mask. So I just go here and I create a layer mask. Yeah, so after that I'm going to bring out the details from the layer which is behind. So I'm going to press B for the brush, and I'm just going to paint carefully over the areas where I want the details to be shown. Okay, so I'm just changing the size of the brush using square brackets, and I'm just going to paint over this area. You see the moment I'm painting, I'm going to get the details of these areas. Okay, and if you think you did a wrong, you can just invert this. So so maybe I would just like to have it like this. Okay, and Yeah, so this is something you have to do as per your own taste, and this is done. So once you are done, you have to just merge. So you have to choose merge layers, and after the merging is done, I'm just going to press Ctrl S or Command S to save it, and this is done. So I will go back to Lightroom and I'll be able to see that picture. So this is my final file. Okay, and on top of that, if you want to do further adjustments, so if you want to use a little dehaze, okay, or a little bit of clarity, so you can use that. So that pretty much brings us to the end of this tutorial. So I hope you learned something, and please subscribe for my channel and like this video if it was helpful, and I'll be back with some more interesting videos. Thank you very much.